Hello and welcome to this tutorial on how to annotate images with VIA, the VGG image annotator. I assume that you already downloaded VIA. If you have not done so already, then please go ahead and follow the link in the video description. Okay, I'm going to open the folder of VIA and start VIA by double-clicking via.html. This is going to open VIA in my default browser. Now I can click Select Images to select our example image. You could also add multiple images at once. So I'm going to select just the single image, and we can see that it's a mixture of spherical and cubic particles. So in order to distinguish these two particle shapes, we need to define an attribute for the shape, and we're going to call it shape. And we click on plus, which adds it. So now we need to select the type of the attribute, and the type should be dropdown, which is going to create a dropdown list where we can choose the particle shape from later on. So the first shape is sphere, and I press enter to edit. And the second shape is cube, and I press enter again. And now I got these two particle shapes, and I can also select a default shape, and I'm going to select sphere because we got more spheres than cubes in our image. Okay, now that I specified the attribute, I can start annotating the image, and I'm going to start with the cubic particles. Therefore, I'm going to pick the polygon region shape. So we can add an annotation or start an annotation by clicking somewhere in the image, and now I defined a point, and I can add more points by clicking on the edge of the particle. And now I'm nearly finished, and I'm at the end of this annotation, so I double click, which finishes the annotation. Okay, so now I accidentally started a new annotation, and I can abort that by hitting escape. Okay, I'm going to go on and annotate the other cubes. And now on purpose I'm going to make a mistake. So you can see that the last point was not placed correctly. So I can change these points by dragging and dropping them wherever I want. I can also move the shape as a whole. I can copy it by pressing Ctrl C and paste it by pressing Ctrl V. And I can also remove the shape by pressing Delete. And now I can move that shape back to its original place by selecting it. Therefore, I click somewhere in the area of the shape, and I drag and drop it to its position. Okay, that's fine. So I can go on and annotate the other cubes. So that's all of the cubes. Now I go on and annotate the other particles, the circular or spherical particles, and therefore I select the circular region shape. And I click in the middle or in the center of a circular particle and drag and drop the circular outline. And I do that for several particles. You can see I misplaced it, so I select the annotation by clicking on it somewhere in the area of the annotation and dragging and dropping it to the correct place. And you can also see that this sort of annotation only has a single point, which lets me define the radius. So now we nearly got all of the particles annotated. But now we still need to define the shape of the annotations, because Via doesn't know which of the annotations are cubes and which of them are spheres. So I select one of the annotations, and you can see that here I can see the attribute, which is shape, and it's sphere, which is correct. But if I click on a cube, you can see that it's also sphere, and that's not a good thing. So this is the drop-down menu that we created before, and we can select cube, and you can see that now shape 2 is correctly identified as a cube. If you want to have a better overview, then you can select an annotation and hover over it with the with your mouse cursor, and then turn your mouse wheel just a single notch, and it will display the attribute that we defined for each of the annotations. Most of them are sphere, because that's our default attribute, and this one is cube, because we just changed it to cube. So now we have to set the cube shape for all of the cube annotations. So we click on it and select cube once again, and now the last one, and now everything is labeled correctly. So we can now go ahead and save these results. Therefore, we click on annotation and select export annotations as JSON, and we save it. And another thing which is very handy for, especially if you have multiple images that you want to annotate, is that you can save your project so that you can, for example, if you need a break, then you can save your project and come back to it later and resume it. And also it's a good thing to save occasionally to make sure that you don't lose any of the progress that you already made, in case that, for example, your system crashes or something like that. Therefore, you click on project and then on save, and you make sure that you selected all of these three checkboxes, and you give a meaningful name to your project. In our case, example project. And you click OK, and click OK once again to save the project. Now, if you had multiple images, you could resume with the next image by pressing the letter N on your keyboard. Obviously, this won't work for me, because I only got a single image. And if you want to look up the keyboard shortcuts, you can expand this menu here below, and you can see N and P, or the arrow keys, are going to switch to the next or previous image. And here are once again all the other shortcuts which I already explained. Okay, that's about it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Have a nice day, and bye bye.